Welcome back. So today I'm going to make a fall stripe tumbler, and I am using double-sided tape. I have taped everything but this last piece to go ahead and get it started for everybody. I base coated the cup white spray paint, just a flat white spray paint from Rust-Oleum. If you hear banging in the background, that would be my son. So for the most part of the whole part of the cup, except for the bottom little lip, which I'll show in a minute, I've used 3 1/4 inch double-sided tape. And then for the top part, I want to say this is probably, honestly, I don't even really know. I got a pack on Amazon that came with 3 different sizes. And this was in it, so I'll have to look and see what size this is, but it's just enough to fit this part that I need to add to the cup, and I've got glitter all over it. So we're going to be doing that. I will post in the description where I got these from Amazon to use. Glitter-wise, I got everything I'm using from Sassencraft Glitter, sassencraft.com. I'll be using Brazil Deep Copper, Fall Orange, Pumpkin Spice, Candy Apple Red, and Champagne Gold. So I'm going to put these all on the cup, and then I will clear coat it with my triple thick glaze high gloss spray paint from Rust-Oleum, and then I will put epoxy on it. And then we will put gold strips to separate the colors out. So we're gonna get started. Pretty much, I'm gonna do this on the top one. You just measure around the cup or cut off a big piece and then cut some extra off is what I do. And then just tape it on the cup like so. If there's excess, that's fine. We can cut that part off or just fold it over. This one doesn't have any excess. Just a tad bit, so we'll fold it over. And then I'm just going around making sure it is butted up. I'm trying to see if I can. It's hard to see the white on white. But I want all of them butted up against each line from the previous layer. This piece off. Start trash pile. So from here, it's just really easy. I'm just gonna peel off each layer. I put them all in the same place so I knew where I could find all of them. That way I'm not going around the whole cup looking for different ends and trying to peel it all off. So I've counted it out. So I've got 5 glitters. The top's going to be a little bit smaller than the other layers from what I've figured. So I'm going to do 3 rows. And 1, 2, 3, 4. Yeah, and then just these 2 rows will be the final color. So let's get started. I'm going to start with the Brazil Deep Copper first. Really need a holder. So I'm gonna peel this back and then I'm gonna peel off. Let me see if there we go. So I peeled this little piece back first. That's the one that still has the tape on it. And then I came down and I unhooked the rest of it, peeled that off, and then I just lightly press it back into place. And then I'm gonna keep doing it without setting it down. For the next 2 rows. I have not made a cup like this before, so this is the first time for all of us. We'll see how it turns out. I do use the double-sided tape a lot. I use them a lot for my plaid. I'll put my plaid together, and then I will go back with a 1/8 strip and put it in between the lines after the epoxy, or no, I haven't done one in a while. I use the epoxy. I'm just using this to push that down on these rows. There we go. So once I've glittered my plaids, then I go back and spray painted them clear coat so that glitter doesn't go everywhere. I go back and I add the 1/8 inch tape, and then that way you can give your plaid a whole different effect by adding additional lines in a different color. So like, I don't know, let's do a 2-on-white cup with this bronze color, copper color. And I mean, the options are endless. I even did a Christmas one where it was green and red all over, and then I went back and did a silver strip down the plaid. So there's anything that you could do. This double-sided tape's amazing. Like I said, just going around. You don't have to worry about the other tape because we haven't peeled that off yet. So just like that, there's our first row. I have this cheap little makeup brush I got from e.l.f. And I'm just gonna just a little bit hit this area, just so when I peel off the tape, I don't get all this excess going. Most of it will come off, I assume. Like I said, we'll figure it out together. But I don't want a whole bunch up here. I'm just pushing it down. And then with the double-sided tape, just to make sure it sticks, I just go back and I lightly. Oh, I missed a spot. There we go. Pat it down just to make sure it's secure. Sorry if I seem distracted. My son just took it upon himself to go out back and jump on the trampoline. Oh, never a dull moment with a 2-year-old. All right. So I'm thinking, since I have 2 oranges, I'm going to do an orange next. And that way it's broken up so we don't have back-to-back oranges everywhere. And then split it up with the gold and the red. I think that'll look best. I don't want my colors to mix, so I just shook off the little bit extra on my paper as I just put more on there. All right, so this one, it's not shiny right now because I sanded it, but I have finished the bottom, like I said, and epoxied it and sanded it down. So now we're going to add our gold strips. I just printed them off Cricut. I did about 10 inches. Sorry about that. Hold on. Open the window to let some fumes out. About 10 inches by 0.3 on my Cricut. So we're just going to peel them off and put them on each new color. I don't really know what you call it. Harsh line, something. and then I've got my X-Acto knife so that we can make sure it's even. And this does not want to peel off. There we go. So I'm just going to put it about as center as I can get it between the two colors and then wrap it all the way around. And once I get to the other side, I'm going to cut off the extra with my X-Acto knife. So that way it goes seam to seam. There we go. I'm just trying to make sure it stays even. And I'm just going to peel it back a little bit so I can see where the seam started. And that way we can go to where the seam ends. Oh, right there. And it is not going to cut for me. We go. So just like that. I'm gonna do the other three, fast forwarding it through so you don't have to sit and wait the whole time. Smooth them down and then we'll go back with epoxy and it'll be done.